Hello everybody, today we are going to start a new concept, that is volume of sphere. Okay, so for that we are going to use, for volume of sphere we are going to use the three formulas. That from that first one is volume of sphere is equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, 4 by 3 pi r cube. Volume of hemisphere is equal to 2 by 3 pi r cube. Volume of hemisphere is equal to 2 by 3 pi r cube. And third one is volume of spherical shell is equal to 4 by 3 pi in bracket capital R cube minus small r cube. So capital R is outer radius and small r is equals to inner radius. Okay, so these three formulas we are going to use for the volume of sphere. Understood? Once again I am repeating here, see, volume of sphere is equals to 4 by 3 pi r cube, complete sphere, whole sphere. Understood? That is 4 by 3 pi r cube. Then second one, volume of hemisphere is equal to 2 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, and volume of spherical shape. Okay, spherical shape means there are two radii. First one is capital R outer radius and inner radius is smaller. So that we have to use 4 by 3 pi r cube minus small r. Okay, so these three formulas we are going to use for the volume of sphere. Okay, so on this basis, a simple example we are going to see initially. That is, first one example is find the volume of sphere of radius 7 cm. Okay, very simple example. The radius is given, radius that is equals to small r, radius is equals to small r, that is 7 cm. Understood? So now here directly we can use volume of sphere is equal to volume of sphere is equals to 4 by 3 pi r cube, cubic units, unit will come in its cube. Okay, so now here 4 by 3 multiplied by pi is 22 by 7, multiplied by r is radius is 7 centimeter is given. So 7 multiplied by 7 centimeter cube. Okay, so here cube is given. So we have to take 7 3 times, we have to multiply 7 3 times. Okay, now only calculations here we have to do. When you solve this, you will get your answer. Okay, so very simple example. So now here this 7 will be cancelled. Okay, so what is remaining? 22 4s are 88 multiplied by 7 7s are 49 divided by 3 centimeter cube. Okay, now when you will solve this, so that time you get 1437.33 centimeter cube. Okay, solve this, you will get answer. Okay, our second problem is a hemispherical bowl is made of steel 0.5 centimeter thick. The inside radius of the bowl is 4 centimeter. Find the volume of steel used in making the bowl. This is the problem. Okay, now see here what is given. First we will see here the hemispherical bowl is made of steel 0.5 centimeter thick. Thickness is given 0.5 centimeter. Okay, the inside radius of the bowl is given 4 centimeter. Inside radius of the bowl, suppose hemispherical bowl, we will make like this. Okay, so this is the thickness. And inside radius is given. So inside radius is 4 centimeter. Inside radius is 4 centimeter. And this thickness is given 0.5 centimeter. This thickness is given 0.5 centimeter. 0.5 centimeter. Understood? These two things are given. And hemispherical bowl is given. Okay. Now of course what is given? Find the volume of steel used in making the bowl. Have to find out volume of the steel. Okay, so if you think about this problem, then what actually we need to do here, let's see carefully. See, first inside radius is given and thickness is given. So with the help of thickness and inner radius, we can find out outer radius, that we will denote by capital. Okay, so that I am taking here small r, inner radius. That is small r is equal to 4 centimeter. Okay, and outer radius the radius of the bound. That is capital R is equal to what? This 4 plus 0.5, that is 4.5 centimeters. So this is the capital R, that is 4.5 centimeters. Okay. Now what we have to find out? We have to find out volume of the steel. Volume of the steel. So here we need to find out volume of the bound whose radius is R, capital R, and volume of the bound whose radius is smaller, that is 4 centimeters. Okay. When you will find out volume of both, that time we need to do subtraction. Then whatever it is remaining, that difference is equal to the volume of steel which is used. Okay, so that we have to find out. Now you will think, can we use this formula, volume of spherical shell? This is volume of spherical shell, this is not a hemisphere. Understood? This is a sphere, complete sphere. It is not given for hemisphere. So for hemisphere we need to find out the inner radius and outer radius. Separately we can find out and then we can find out difference. Okay. So here accordingly I am going to do here. So see carefully. So first we will find out volume of inner, okay, volume of inner bound. Inner bound. Okay, so that will be 2 by 3. This is hemisphere. So we have to use this formula 2 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, 2 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, so now here 2 by 3 pi r cube is equal to what? We can write here 2 by 3 multiplied by pi is 22 by 7. And radius, inner radius, what is inner radius? 4 centimeters. So we can write here 4 multiplied by 4 because 2. R cube. So 4 into 4 into 4. So this will give you volume of inner bound. Understood? So we will be, this is the first thing. Okay. Now secondly we will think about outer, volume of outer bound. Okay, whose radius is capital R. Okay, the same formula we are going to use, 2 by 3 pi r cube. Only here the radius will be different, that is capital R, that is 4.5 centimeters. So here we can write 2 by 3 multiplied by 22 by 7 multiplied by capital R is 4.5. 4.5 multiplied by 4.5 multiplied by 4.5 centimeter cube, and here also centimeter cube will go. Okay. Now we have to find out the difference between these two. Okay. So volume of steel. What they are asking? Volume of steel. Volume of steel is equal to what? This volume, definitely outer volume will be greater than the inner volume. So that I am taking 2 by 3 into 22 by 7 into 4.5 into 4.5 into 4.5 minus this inner volume, that is 2 by 3 into 22 by 7 into 4 into 4 into 4, or you can write 4 cube also. Outside it will come centimeter cube. Okay. Now which is the common factor? Which are the common factor? These two we can take outside. So that I am taking 22 twos are 44 directly taking outside. 7 threes are 21. So what is going to remain in bracket? 4.5 to 4.5 into 4.5. So that is 4.5 cube minus, this is already taken outside, 4 into 4 into 4, that will be 4. Now it is very simple, so we can write here is equal to 44 upon 21 multiplied by 4.5 cube of 4.5 is 91,125, means 45. So we can put decimal point 91,125. This is the cube of 45. So here 4.5 is after 3d, here multiplying 4.5 3 times, so after 3d in decimal point we will put here, okay, 91,125 minus 4 cube is 64. Okay, 4 cube is 64. So now we have to do this, we have to do this subtraction and then you will get your answer. Okay, so now this is equal to 44 upon 21 multiplied by 91 minus 64. 91 minus 64 will be 27. 27.125.
22. Okay, so we need to find out this product, 44 multiplied by 27.125. That product is 1193.5 divided by 22. Okay, divided by 22, and this answer will be 56.83 centimeter. Okay, this calculation I am not showing here, you can do. Understood? So see carefully what we have done. This was the inner radius and outer radius. These two things are given. This outer radius was not given. That we have to find out with the help of thickness. Okay, so that we have done first. This is inner radius was given. Outer radius we have done 4 plus 0.5, that is thickness. Then volume of inner bound. Okay, so that is 2 by 3 part small r. So that we have done here. Volume of outer bound, that is again the same formula, only radius will be different. So 2 by 3, 22 by 7, so you will get, and we need to find out difference. Why difference? Because this whole volume and this volume, we have to find out volume of the steel which is used to make the bow. Okay, so for that we have done here, we have to find out the difference. So difference you will get, you can get common factors that will make the sum more easy. Okay, so 44 by 21 into 27.125. This product is 1193.5 divided by 21, and this product is, sorry, this division is 56.8 centimeter cube. So this is our final answer. Okay. Our third problem is hemispherical spherical bowl has inner diameter 11.2 centimeter. Find the volume of mean it can hold. Okay, very simple example. Diameter is given. Diameter is given 11.2 centimeter. So here I am taking that diameter of bowl is equal to 11.2 centimeters. Okay, so now here we can find out radius. Radius is equal to what? 11.2 divided by 2. So that is 5.6 centimeters. So radius we have 5.6 centimeters. Okay, and this is hemispherical bowl. Directly it is given. So directly we can use formula, volume of bowl is equal to 2 by 3 pi r cube. 2 by 3 pi r cube. So here 2 by 3 into pi is 22 by 7 multiplied by r. Radius is 5.6 into 5.6 centimeter cube. Okay, so now here 56 is divisible by 7, so 7 8s are 56, so it will be 0.8. understood? Now here 22 to the 44 upon 3 multiplied 0.8 into 5.6 into 5.6, so it will be 25. This product is coming 25.088 centimeter cube. Okay, centimeter cube. Understood? Now we need to find out product of this. So 44 multiplied by 25.088, so it will be 1103.872 divided by 3. Okay, so here this, now again we need to divide this, so here you will get 367.9573 something you will get. It will be not terminated, so we can write this 367.96 centimeter cube. 367.96 centimeter cube. So this is the answer of this question. Okay, but they are asking find the volume of milk it can hold. Okay, but generally we give, this is capacity. Okay, so we give answer in liter or milliliter. Okay, so we can convert this into milliliter very easily, because 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1 milliliter. Very simple ratio. 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1 milliliter. So this 367.96, it will be directly we can write in milliliter. Okay, so capacity, or what, find the volume of milk. Volume of milk is equal to 367.96 millimeters. 366.67.96 millimeter. Okay, so this is our answer. Generally, we express this answer type of capacity means in milliliter, liter. Okay, so we have to do this. Okay. Okay, our next problem is find the volume of sphere whose surface area is 154 centimeter square. Okay, surface area is given. Understood? So we know that surface area of sphere is equal to 4 pi r square. Understood? And that is given 154 centimeter square. So this we can equate with 154. Okay, so I am taking that 4 pi r square is equal to 154. Okay, so now here 4 multiply by 22 by 7 into r square is equal to 154. So here r square is equal to 154 multiply by this 7 divided by 22 into 4. Okay, so 154 is divisible by 22. 22 ones are 22, 7s are. Okay, so r square is equal to 7 sevens are 49 upon 4. So r is equal to, we can write 7 by 2 centimeters. Radius we got 7 by 2 centimeters. Okay, radius is 7 by 2 centimeters. Without radius, we cannot find out volume. Understood? So now here we have to find the volume of sphere whose surface area is 154. So with the help of that, we got here radius. Now we can find out volume of sphere is equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. 4 by 3 pi r. So that is 4 upon 3 multiplied by 22 by 7 into 7 by 2 is the radius, so that we need to take 7 by 2 centimeter cube. Okay, so now here we can cancel this. 7 will be cancelled. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. This 2 will be cancelled. So 2 1s are 2, 11 are. So what is remaining here? 1 by 3, this is 1 by 3, multiply by 11, multiply by 7 into 7, 7 multiplied by 7 centimeter cube. Okay, so this 11 7 is 77 into 7 upon 3. So you will get this answer 179.66 centimeter cube. 179.66 centimeter cube. So this is the volume of that sphere. Okay, very simple example. Only here radius was not given directly. The radius we have to find out with the help of given things, and with the help of radius we have to find out volume. Okay, thank you.